Isang masayang pagbati na may ngiti sa aking mga labi. Naghahanap ba kayo ng makakatuwang sa pag-review ng inyong anak? Meron yan sa DepEd. Ang ETUlay online tutorial ay libre at handog ng ating kagawaran sa pangunguna ng OUA ICTS EdTech. Ito ay isang proyektong makatutulong sa mga mag-aaral, katuwang ang mga magulang o kasama sa kani-kanilang tahanan para masagutan at maunawaan ang mga modules. Hangad din ng programang ETUlay ang matulungan ang ating mga guro sa kanilang mga blended learning classes. Ang ating ETUlay ay mula kinder hanggang senior high school. Bukod sa academics, meron din tayong mga special programs gaya ng All is Wellness, Reading and Math Remediation, Storytelling, Mommy Tech Talks, Classes sa Gramatika, Speech Class, Financial Literacy, at marami pang iba. Pinalawig din ng ETUlay ang ating Alive Program para sa mga mag-aaral mula grade 1 hanggang grade 3. Gayun din ay mayroon tayong IELTS Program at SPED Tutorials na makasisigurong makakamit ng lahat ang inclusive education. May SPED hotline na rin para sa inyong mga katanungan patungkol sa special education. Kaya, subaybayan mula Lunes hanggang Biyernes, mula ika-9 ng umaga hanggang ika-7 ng gabi ang ating ETUlay. Sa ating pagtutulungan, maiaangat natin ang bawat isa.
Calling all senior high school students! Let us all be super this second semester! Join your volunteer ETUlay tutors for science and technology subjects every Monday and be hashtag mahusay. Explore the incredible world of physical science with Tutor Lester and Tutor Nell, 4 o'clock to 4:40 p.m. Be internet smart and discover more about the different ICT tools that you can use on Empowerment Technologies together with Tutor Jane and Tutor Janelle, 4:40 to 5:20 p.m. Let Tutor Edson, Tutor Echo, and Tutor Leo guide you on how to be prepared for various hazards on disaster readiness and risk reduction, 4 o'clock to 4:40 p.m. And learn the concepts of genetics, biodiversity, anatomy and physiology, and evolution on General Biology 2 with Tutor Easter and Tutor Tina, 4:40 to 5:20 p.m. Be part of our team and be hashtag mahusay!
Mabuhay! Good day to all! I am your Tutor Madge. Welcome to ETUlay, a free online tutorial, an initiative of the Department of Education, Information and Communications Technology Service, Educational Technology Unit, ICTS EdTech. This program is aimed at helping and assisting learners from kindergarten, senior high school, ALS, Alive, and SPED learners. Aside from answering the modules, the ETUlay is offering programs which you will surely look forward to. Together with our parents and teachers, the ETUlay will bridge the gaps where difficulty and ease meet in learning new knowledge and skills. So, let us prepare our modules, pen and paper. Ready your mind to see and hear worthwhile and interesting lessons. Let us now study and learn together with our volunteer online tutors. Tara na!
Ayan, hello. Good afternoon. Isang napakagandang hapon ulit sa inyong lahat. Ayan. At isang maligayang pagbabalik dito sa ating ETUlay Physical Science Live Session. Kumusta kayong lahat? Sana kayo ay nasa maayos na kalagayan. Ako nga pala ang inyong tutor ngayong araw na ito, Tutor Nell from SDO Pasig City. Ngayong araw, ang ikatlong linggo sa fourth quarter ng physical science. Handa na ba kayong matuto? Pero, bago ang lahat, i-like at i-share ninyo sa inyong mga newsfeed ang ating live session para naman mas lalo pang dumami ang ating physical science family. At syempre, sa mga walang sawang sumusuporta sa ating mga live sessions, maraming maraming salamat po. Narito ang ating mga most essential learning competencies o MELCs na i-cover natin for this week. Una, explain the wave and particle model of light. Next, describe the reflection and refraction in terms of wave and particle models of light. And the last one is explain the propagation of light using the wave and particle models. Bago natin i-discuss ang ating topic, mag-review muna tayo ng ating mga past discussions. Last session, the following things were discussed. The first one is the concept of motion was explained by Aristotle and Galileo. Both of their ideas contributed to the modern understanding of motion. Diba? Naaalala nyo ba yung mga pinag-usapan natin about sa motion? Paano nga ulit nagkaiba ang ideas nila Aristotle at Galileo with regards to this concept? Yan. And do you still remember yung pinakitang experiment ni Galileo about the free fall motion? The relationship of how things free falling in motion should be in real life. Okay? Another one, aside from motion, we also talk about inertia. Yeah. Inertia was first explained by Galileo, and this understanding became the basis of the first law of motion formulated by Isaac Newton. So these two concepts were the center of our discussion last meeting. Anong concepts ang naging memorable sa inyo during our last discussion? Sige nga, let me see. From our comments. Ayan. Sa ating mga live viewers, ano ba yung topic or ginawa natin last session na hindi nyo nakalimutan until now, no? Even though we took a break for almost 2 weeks, no? From our discussions. Comment sila. So good afternoon po sa ating mga live viewers na nandirito na ngayon. Okay? So keep them coming. Like and share na po yung ating mga live session para mas dumami pa tayo ngayong araw. Okay, so let's proceed. Okay. Now let us get started with the topic. Ang topic natin for today ay about propagation of light as explained by the wave and particle models. So ibig sabihin, ang ating topic will be focusing on the properties and nature of lights. Theories about life. Sa loob ng napakahabang panahon ay naging isang malaking discussion among the scientific community kung paano ba nila i-describe ang light, 'di ba? Yung liwanag. For example, yung liwanag ng araw, paano ba nila i-describe or i-explain yung ganong klaseng phenomena? May mga eksperto na nagsasabi na ang light ay isang wave. Okay? Isang wave na parang tubig. Ngunit, meron din namang mga naniniwala na ang light ay binubuo ng mga maliliit na particles. Or just like, for example, is yung grains of rice na parang maliliit na butil ng bigas. So, these two groups of scientific communities were in contradiction with about the true nature of light. Light as a wave and light as a particle. Before we discuss the theories regarding the nature of light, we need to understand first how scientists explained the emergence of colors of light. So, alam naman natin ngayon na ang white light, no, yung kulay puting ilaw, ay consists of different colors of light like what you are seeing in this light. So basically, ito po yung light, o ito yung colors of light na makikita natin sa isang rainbow, di ba? So For some time, this emergence of colors were one of the topics scientists wants to explain. So they were wondering bakit ba nagkakaroon ng different colors of light from a single strand of white light. Okay. One of the first scientists who tried to explain the emergence of colors is René Descartes. He used a spherical glass filled with water and sunlight to produce a rainbow. He explained that refraction brought about the formation of rainbows. He then used a prism to observe the emergence of colors of light. René Descartes visualized that the plenum was made of tiny rotating balls with the same speed. Light traveled through this plenum, and as the plenum reached the edge of a prism, the balls changed their rotational speed, resulting to the emergence of colors. He said that the plenum was made of tiny rotating balls with the same speed. Ayan. So he explained, so yung plenum daw is yung mga maliliit na rotating balls. So when this plenum changes the rotational speed, it is actually the reason why the colors of light emerges. That is according to René Descartes. Another scientist who attempted to explain the colors produced by light is Sir Isaac Newton. He studied the emergence of colors of light using a prism. According to him, particles of matter also exert equal force to the particles of light. The colors of light with different mass and inertia will be deflected at varying degrees. When they pass through an interface of matter, light particles with greater mass and inertia are deflected less when acted upon by the same force of matter. So that is why yung mga different bands of colors ng light, ibig sabihin, according to Sir Isaac Newton, meron siyang iba't ibang amount ng mass and inertia. That is why kapag nag-pass through yung isang light particle o yung isang light through a prism, nagkakaroon ng disbandment between the different colors based on the amount of mass or particle present in the light. So as the two describes how the colors of light emerge, they also describe the nature of light as a wave and as a particle. So unknowingly, the two scientists were able to explain the emergence of light in two different views. One of them views light as a wave, and the other one views light as a particle. So the dual nature of light can be witnessed when we let a light pass on a screen with two slits. Yeah. So tingnan natin yung dalawang pictures na nandirito. Okay? In the first picture, as you can see, when we have the light here, light source natin dito, monochromatic light, ibig sabihin kulay red lang to. Okay? And then there is a slit or parang hiwa. Mapapansin nyo dito na what will happen is the lights will just pass through this slit. Okay? And then, doon sa kabilang side, makikita mo pa rin yung mga light particles natin dito. Okay? The other one is like this. When you have a monochromatic light coming from this source, and then you have a slit here, what will happen is, para nagkakaroon ng diffraction or interference yung ating mga lights dito. So parang nagkakaroon siya ng ripple effect, just like how waves of water occur, 'di ba? Parang waves ng water yung pangalawang picture. Ayan. So in the first picture, the light will pass through forming the shape of the slit just like the particles will do. And in the second pictures, the light will pass through the slit just like how the wave of water will do. So ito yung dual nature ng light. So some says that light is a particle, some naman light is a wave. Now, isa-isahin po natin. First, let's talk about light as a particle. One of the first scientists that explained that light is a particle is none other than Sir Isaac Newton. He proposed the corpuscular or particle theory of light. So according to Newton, light was a particle because the edges of the shadow it created were extremely sharp and clear. He named the theory corpuscular theory because he believed that the particle, the light particle, is called corpuscles. Now, another scientist who supported the particle theory of light is Albert Einstein. So he revived the theory of Newton and said that light is made up of particles he called photons. So in summary, the following characteristics of lights were observed that prove that light is a particle. Number one, light travels in a straight line. Number two, light was able to reflect or changes direction. And number three, it has something to do with the refraction of light or the bending in going from one material to another. Yeah. Now let's move on to light as a wave. About the same time as Newton, so halos magkasabayan silang dalawa ni Newton, so Newton proposed light as a particle. At the same time, merong isang Dutch physicist with the name of Christian Huygens that believed that light was made out of waves. So made up of waves. So Huygens said that light was made up of waves vibrating up and down perpendicular to the direction of the light travels. So naniniwala siya na ang light daw ay isang transverse wave. No, yung parang, di ba pag meron kayong slinky, alam nyo yung slinky, yung parang laruan na, yung gumaganong-ganong na laruan. So, when you move the slinky up and down, okay, yun po yung itsura ng how lights travel according to Christian Huygens. Or halimbawa, kapag meron kang rope, a piece of rope, tapos itali mo yung rope sa isang end, and then ihampas mo yung rope ng pagganito, yung way the rope move, okay, that is how light waves moves according to Christian Huygens. Okay? So there are three, so these are the three properties of light that can be proved that light is a wave. So number one is interference. Ibig sabihin, waves superpose and pass right through each other. Number two is yung diffraction. Waves spills over the edges of their obstructions. And number three, polarization or eliminating one of light's field. Ayan. So in conclusion, light is a form of energy. Sometimes it behaves like particle and sometimes it behaves like a wave. So in the past, in the scientific community, lagi nagkakatalo yung idea ng light being a particle and then yung idea ng light being a wave. Pero it come to a conclusion na light ay merong dual nature. Ibig sabihin, light has a property of a particle but also has a property of wave. Kaya nga meron tayong tinatawag na dual nature of light. Kasi light can be both described as a particle and as a wave. So, from the theories brought forward by Newton and Huygens, we can say that light behaves both as a wave and as a particle. As a particle, no, light travels in a straight line and explains why shadows are formed. Light as a particle also explains why light is reflected off in the mirrors. It also explains the refraction of light when it travels through different media. Let us say, for example, from air to water, in which light has different speed respectively. Light also acts as a wave. It has the ability to diffract or bend around an object. Diffraction involves a change in direction of waves when they pass from an opening or around obstacles along their different refractive indices, say, water and air. Light waves also undergo interference, the phenomenon that occurs when two waves meet while traveling along the same medium. Okay. Now, in terms of the phenomenon of reflection, light as a particle behave as follows. So, as you can see, upon arriving at the smooth surface, the particles bounce off in different points, so their order in the beam is reversed, resulting to a reverse image of a virtual image. Okay. As a wave naman, hitting a smooth surface like a mirror, light bounce off or reflect according to the arrival angle or the angle of incidence. The front of the wave turns into the back of the waves as they are reflected, and that is the reason why they produce a reverse or virtual image. In terms of refraction naman, refracting particles of light should also change direction upon passing between two mediums. It is suggested in this theory that there is a force which is perpendicular to the boundary between the first and the second medium, let us say from air to water, just like what is in the figure, and acts to change the speed of the particles as they enter the second medium, resulting to bending of the light particles. So, in the diagram, as you can see here, itong mga particles ng light natin initially is in the air, and then eventually it passes through a different medium, in this case, water. So nakita nyo yung bending, yung change of speed because of the change in the type of medium. And then eventually comes back to the initial way it is oriented because bumalik siya doon sa kanyang initial na medium. Okay? Now, same thing happened with light as waves. It changes direction upon passing the first medium to second medium. A small portion of each angled wavefront should impact the second medium before the rest of the front reaches the interface. This part will travel along the second medium while the rest of the waves is still traveling in the first medium. Movement will be slower through the second medium due to higher refractive index. Since the wavefronts are traveling at different speeds, light will bend into the second medium, thus changing the angle of propagation. So reflection of light, especially when light reflects off a very smooth surface, results to image being formed. The example of a very smooth surface that can perfectly reflect light are called mirrors, no, yung mga salamin. The images formed by mirrors are either virtual or real depending on the reflecting surface. Okay, now let's talk about different mirrors. An example of this mirror is a plane mirror. Ayan. A plane mirror has a surface that is perfectly flat. Now, from the name itself, plane mirror. Plane mirror produces a specular or regular reflection. Okay? So, this is an example of a plane mirror. Yung nakita nyo sa gitna na tawag dito, barrier. This is actually the mirror reflected in this diagram. And then ito, yung mata dito is the observer. Okay? A plane mirror produces a virtual image. Now, how do we explain a virtual image? Yeah. Di ba kapag nakaharap kayo sa flat mirror at ginalaw natin yung ating kanang kamay, halimbawa ito kayo, ginalaw ko yung kanang kamay ko, in our reflection, it looks like we move our left hand instead. No? So when we look at the ray diagram at the slide, we can see that the image is formed behind the mirror. Okay? So itong kulay blue na to na image, ito, this is actually the virtual image formed by the plane mirror. Itong kulay pula, this is actually the real objects. Okay? So, as an observer, What you will see from the mirrors are the virtual image formed here, right behind the mirror itself. Okay. They also have what we call a convex mirror. So like the plane mirror, convex mirrors produce a virtual image, but it is different to the plane mirror. Now, where does the convex mirror curve? Yan, ito yung example ng convex mirror based on our picture, no? So it curves outward, no? And because of that, it can reflect a wide angles and can provide a wider field of view compared to the plane mirrors. Convex mirrors, these kinds of mirrors are used as side mirrors in vehicles. Syempre, para mas malaki or mas malawak yung viewing field ng ating mirror compared to regular flat mirrors. So how does the image compare to the object in a convex mirror as shown in the ray diagram? So tingnan niyo yung ray diagram dito. So the image is smaller than the object. So makikita po natin that the image is still located behind the mirror. So ito yung real object natin. Ito po yung ating convex mirror. Okay, and then the image that will be formed is found here. This is much smaller compared to the regular object. Kaya nga yung field of view na produce ng convex mirror ay much bigger or wider compared to the field of view that is being produced by a plane mirror. Okay? Yeah. We also have what we call concave mirrors. Yeah. So what do you observe of the image formed in the concave mirror? Ayan, tingnan niyo yung image na na-form sa concave mirror. Ayan. Tingnan niyo. Okay, so the image appears inverted, no? Nakabaliktad. A concave mirror's reflective surface curves inward. So kung yung convex is outward yung kanyang curvature, yung concave naman ay paloob. Okay? So concave mirror produces real and inverted images. So please look at the ray diagram. Ayan. So what is the orientation and the location of the image? Ayan. So tingnan natin yung ating ray diagram. So ito po yung ating real object. Okay? Ito yung ating concave mirror. And then, ito po yung ating image. So as you can see, the image is inverted. Smaller and also inverted from the field of view or point of view of the observer. Okay? Ayan. So real image are formed in front of mirrors and are inverted. So if the object is located between the focus and the reflecting surface, the image is formed behind the mirror is larger. Okay? Ayan. All right. So okay pa ba kayo? wait lang. Check natin yung ating mga live viewers for today. Kung marami-rami na tayo ngayon. Ah, marami-rami na tayo, no? Bumalik na sila. Okay. So welcome back po sa ating sessions bago tayo magpatuloy, no? Sa aking discussion. Ayan. So thank you pa rin po sa ating pagtutok, no? And walang sawang pagsubaybay sa ating mga live sessions for physical science. Okay? So let us continue. So now we're going to talk about the propagation of light. So as we all have learned in our junior high school physics, light is an electromagnetic wave having both magnetic field and electric field components which are vibrating and traveling at a speed of 299,792,458 meters per second in a vacuum. Okay? So the visible lights can be found in the electromagnetic spectrum. The electromagnetic spectrum is composed of waves of varying frequencies, each with unique wavelengths. So andito po yung visible light sa part na to ng ating electromagnetic spectrum. Andito siya. Okay, ayan. Yung may light bulb na part. Okay. Visible white light vibrate at different frequencies and can be dispersed through a prism. This is actually what Sir Isaac Newton and Rene Descartes were trying to explain back in the past, diba? Yung emergence of colors from white light. So the image in the slide shows us the white light dispersed into different colors when it is refracted through a prism. Each wavelength or colors of white light has a different wavelength, implying that each wavelength has different speeds upon entering the prism. So as you can see, ito actually yung ginawang experiments nila Rene Descartes and Sir Isaac Newton during their time, no? Tawag dito, they let a white light pass through a prism and then eventually they observe yung different colors ng white light, no? Yung colors ng rainbow, no? Yung Roy G. Biv. So to propagate light, it can be reflected, absorbed, or transmitted or refracted. So that is how you propagate or produce light. Okay. So when light falls on a very smooth surfaces, it produces a specular reflection that can produce image that our eyes can perceive. Ayan. And lights of a certain wavelengths or colors are absorbed and reflected with the reflected wavelength visible to the observers. So for example, ayan daw, no? So kapag meron kang object, for example, itong green na dahon, no, green leaf, white light coming in, so all the colors of light will be absorbed other than the color of the material itself. So in this case, kung ang kulay po ng dahon ay green, yung green light will be reflected and that will be the color that will be observed by our eyes, no? Yung na-reflect na color ng light. And then the rest of the lights will be absorbed by the material. So that's why yung leaves natin appears to be green because it reflects the green light. Okay? So, kamusta naman ang ating mga live viewers ngayon? Check nga natin kung marami ba kayong tutunan sa ating discussion. Tingnan natin kung sino-sino yung mga nasa live viewers. Check natin kung mayroon ba tayong nadagdag na ibang schools. Ayan, so shout out ka sa mga estudyante and teachers from Padre Garcia National High School. Ayan, good afternoon. And we also have Godofredo Reyes Senior National High School from SDO Camarines Sur. Ayan, so good afternoon din po sa inyong lahat. We also have students from san pa ba to? And we also have students from Buting Senior High School. Ayan, kung saan po ako nagtuturo. Ayan, so good afternoon sa aking mga students. Ayan, binibigyan ko ng link kanina. We also have, ayan, from, ayan, Sally Lorenzo Sarmiento Senior National High School. Ayan, parang bago yon, no? Parang first time natin magkaroon ng audience from that school. Ayan, so welcome po sa atin dito sa ating live session. So hinagahanap ko ng mga ano eh, ng mga bago nating baka nadagdag na mga schools, no? Ayan, maghanap tayo para naman mabati natin sila, no? Ayan. So don't forget to like and share and then of course comment your name and then your schools and divisions para naman ma-recognize namin kayo sa susunod na sessions natin. Ayan. So tignan ko nga sa ayan, so siya, ayan, so let me now present to you our learners na nanonood sa atin ngayon ng inyong activity. So visit the link and Visit the link and download the crossword puzzle about light and upload your answers on the same link. So, I will give you a link. Ito, itong link na to. So, the link is https://bit.ly/3jrftcl. So, the link in there, meron kayong i-download na file. Tapos, at the same time, doon sa mismong link, you will upload your answers na rin. Okay, same link lang po tayo. So you may submit your output in any digital format na makikita nyo sa inyong mga screen. So babasahin ko lang yung link, no? Same link lang kanina, that is bit.ly/3jrftcl. So enter your name, your grade and section, name of the teacher, school and SDO, and upload your output to be recognized. So the output can be in any format possible like Word, PDF, or JPEG. Hihintayin po namin ang inyong mga submissions, mga live viewers. Yeah. So in summary na po tayo, when light falls on a very smooth surfaces, okay, so the particle and wave theories of light were proposed by Newton's and Huygens respectively. Yeah. And light can be reflected, refracted, or absorbed. Alright, so now let's move on to our quiz segment na pinapangalanan po nating Gets Mo, Sagot Mo. So na-miss nyo ba yung segment na ito? Yan, sa segment na ito ay may sasagutan po tayo yung mga limang questions na of course taken from what we had shared to you earlier. We are inviting you, our live viewers, to have fun and sumali po kayo sa ating Gets Mo, Sagot Mo segment. Just comment po your answers in the comment section. Okay, let's get started. Number one. He proposed that light is composed of particles that are traveling in straight line. A. Max Planck. B. Isaac Newton. C. Louis de Broglie. D. Christian Huygens. Ayan, sige nga, let me see your answers. Mga live viewers, so comment lang po yung inyong sagot. Ayan, hintayin ko kayong sumagot ha bago ko ibigay yung tamang sagot. Okay, ayan, meron ng mga sumasagot. Mm-hmm. Okay. Okay. Okay, the correct answer is letter B, Isaac Newton. Okay? Next, number two. What evidence tells that light is made up of particles traveling in a straight line? A. Inversion of image formed on plane mirrors. B. Formation of shadows when light hits obstacles. C. Production of ripples when a coin is dropped to a pond. Or D. Scattering of light rays when they reach a smooth surface. Okay, so what will be your answer? Okay, so the answer is letter B, formation of shadows when light hits obstacles. Okay, number three, what is the speed of light as it propagates through space? A, 1.0 times 10 raised to 8 meters per second. B, 2.0 times 10 raised to 8 meters per second. C, 3.0 times 10 raised to 8 meters per second. Or letter D, 4.0 times 10 raised to 8 meters per second. Okay. So what will be your answers? Okay, may mga sumasagot na. Okay. Okay. The correct answer is letter C, 3.0 times 10 raised to 8 meters per second. Number 4. A student placed a pencil in a glass of water as shown in the figure. Why did the pencil appear to be broken? A. Light always travels in a straight line. B. Light makes the water evaporate into the air. C, light reflects the pencil on the water surface. Or letter D, light bends when it passes through changing medium like air and water. So the answer is letter D. Light bends when it passes through changing medium like air and water. Okay, last question. Why do most leaves appear green to our sight? A. All the colors of white light are absorbed by the leaves. B. The particles of light are scattered by the molecules of the green leaves. C. Most of the colors of incident white light are reflected from the leaves except green. Or letter D, the colors of white light are absorbed by the leaves and green waves are reflected. Okay. The answer is letter D. Okay. So, ilan lang nakuha ninyong tamang sagot from our segment for this week. So, I hope nakakuha kayo ng maraming tamang sagot, no? Ayan. So, ang paksan na ating tinalakay ngayong hapon ay nakabatay po sa content ng Physical ADM Modules 10 ng Region 4A Calabarzon. Salamat po sa inyong pagsama sa amin nakaraang 40 minutes na umatikabong live session patungkol sa propagation of light. We are inviting everyone to send us your feedback because it matters to us very much. If you are using a device with a QR code scanner, you may scan the code na makikita po sa inyong mga screen. Or you may screenshot this screen for you to scan it later. You may also type in your web browser the link displayed at the bottom area of the screen, tinyurl.com/ETUlayFeedbackForm. You may also send your words of appreciation po using this link given. You can also give recommendation if you want someone to be our guest in the live stream next session. We would very much welcome them. You may also email your comments and suggestions to the email that you can read in your screens, edtech@deped.gov.ph. Inaanyayahan po namin kayo, aming mga minamahal na mga live viewers, na sabayan rin po ang ating mga tutors sa General Biology 2 na sina Tutor Easter ng SDO Caloocan City at Tutor Tina ng SDO Pasig City after this session from 4:40 to 5:20. You may also watch the live session in Empowerment Technologies kasama ang ating mga tutors na sina Tutor Jane ng SDO Puerto Princesa City at Tutor Junel ng SDO Ilocos Sur right after the session then from 4:40 to 5:20. So that's it for this week. Number 3, supportahan din po natin ang mga tutors from different subject areas of senior high school. Huwag pong kalilimutan from 4 to 5:20 in the afternoon. See you on Monday mula 4 to 4:40 p.m. This is your tutor, Tutor Ronel from SDO Pasig City. Goodbye and thank you.
Ang husay naman! Natapos mo ang iyong tutorial session kasama ang iyong mahusay na ETUlay tutor. May bago ka bang natutuhan? I-share na yan gamit ang hashtag ETUlay Level Up. Huwag aalis ha dahil may susunod pang programa na pwede mo rin panoorin at salihan dahil naghihintay na ang iyong mga tutors. Happy learning dito sa ETUlay!